Myself, Shweta Shah. I am teaching social science in Army Public School, Ambala, Kent. Today, the topic of my video is the French Revolution. First, we must understand why do we require this chapter to be part of the syllabus. Basically, the life we are enjoying today was brought down to us by these kind of few revolutions. This is the only revolution which has given us the tagline of liberty, fraternity, and equality. So basically, it is very, very crucial for us to understand this chapter and understand the events throughout the revolution. Let us begin with the chapter. The society was divided in a very, very distorted kind of a structure. Here we could see in the map the Kingdom of France, and this structure here was called as Old Regime, and it also had a monarch ruling there with absolutism. That means all the powers of legislature, executive and judiciary of present day government were all in the hands of the monarch. What happened in the old regime? There were three estates. First estate, high-ranking members of the church and the privileged class were part of it. Second estate, nobility and the privileged class. Third estate, everyone left, as well as the bourgeois or the wealthy merchants. This is the table showing that what kind of privileges were being accepted for first estate and the second estate. They did not pay any kind of tax. But if we look at the burdens of the third estate, they have to pay all kind of taxes, tithe to the church and tele, which was the land tax. So from here we can very well evaluate that the first and the second estate were reared up by the third estate. The condition was critical for the third estate because the divine rights of the kings were too much. He said that power was given by the God and nobody is going to question it. This is a picture of Palace of Versailles that was being extravagantly taken up by the court. What did the king did? He appointed the people who could collect the taxes. Controlled justice by appointing judges, controlled the military, made the laws, made decisions regarding war and peace, levied all the taxes. This is what I'm telling you. All the powers were concentrated in the hands of the monarch. Let us see the situation. When King Louis XVI came into power, it was a kind of a bankrupt government. Queen Marie Antoinette, she was also very, very extravagant. The government found its funds depleted as a result of funding of American Revolution and a lot of deficit spending was done. That means more of expenditure and less of revenue. Economic conditions were poor as agrarian economy it was, and poor harvests were very common because of the subsistence crisis which was the outcome of it. Bourgeois, the new rich merchants, often managed to gather wealth but were upset that they had to pay the taxes. This is a picture of the Queen. Let us discuss the causes of the French Revolution. Absolutism, I have already told. The old regime, the structure, poor harvests, influence of the Enlightenment of the philosophers. It was by philosophers like Jean-John Locke, Montesquieu, Rousseau. And it was a follow-up of the Renaissance period. Must mention, system of mercantilism has raised a rich class of merchants. They demanded some rights for themselves. Influence of the successful revolutions nearby, the American Revolution especially. Other causes, bankruptcy was there. So they asked for a proposal that they should take up more taxation and it was put down. Then subsistence crisis, famines, hunger, and poor conditions throughout. And the estate journal was just a meeting which was called to cover up all the situations. Let us see what happened. First and the second estate, they both were having a good sitting arrangement there. That means they had a good say as well. And the third estate was not even able to come inside the hall. And therefore, they felt a lot of humiliation. They felt as if they were not heard as always. So they went away to the tennis court, and Abbe sees and Mirabeau, both of them gave wonderful speeches to the people that just revolutionized the brains of the people. And finally, they could reach the National Assembly. And the National Assembly, where we could see France becoming a constitutional monarchy. This is the picture. Four phases of the French Revolution. The National Assembly, we discussed, constitutional monarchy was formed. Then Legislative Assembly, where we could see the government turning into a republic. Then Convention, it was a period of reign of terror. And lastly, Directory. First, the National Assembly, we have discussed, it was a written constitution given. Constitutional monarchy was established. And Bastille was stormed because it was considered as a representative to the position of the monarch. Changes: abolishment of guilds and labor unions, abolition of special privileges, a constitution was formed, declaration of the rights of men was framed, equality before the law only for men, so reforms in local government, taxes levied based on the ability to pay. What was the declaration that was done for rights of men? Freedom of religion, speech, press, whatever we could find today as part of our constitution was laid down and framed here. What did it say? France became a constitutional monarchy. King was just a head of the state now. We had a legislative assembly. Feudalism was abolished. Voting rights were given to limited people, those who were paying the taxation, those who own good properties. Legislative Assembly. Royal family sought help from Austria. A secret pact was made with the Prussian king. Nobles thought that it could be old regime could be bring down back or restored in the France. And church officials also wanted their position back. But it was a time period where they could not reach all this. Marseille was sung. And the army put them all down. Here we could see a convention was placed, an elected assembly, and France became a republic. There was a major role of the political parties, Girondists and Jacobins. Jacobins became more popular. Abolishment of the monarchy was a very obvious thing which happened there. King Louis XVI was guillotined, Marie Antoinette as well. Daughter was allowed to go to Vienna, and son was just beaten up in prison up till he died. This is a picture of the guillotine. Reign of Terror was brought down because of Robespierre. Basically, he wanted all the changes which were the call of French Revolution very quickly and with severe conditions. His ways and means were very hard and harsh. Whatever he took up as measures were very good enough. Meat and bread were rationed, all the salutations were taken away. But he guillotined all the people. That means he killed all those people, those who did not believe accordingly. But he did not understand the concept that the society does not changes in one day. It takes a lot of time. He was not ready to accept the fact that people will not change in a day. So, guillotine machine which was invented to cut the heads of the people brutally, that machine was itself used for himself because of his unpopular means of doing all that. Government under the Directory. This is because Robespierre's party was an elected and the most popular one, represented one. So they could find that if the power is given in the hands of one person, it will create a problem. If it creates a problem, that means the power should be given in more than one hands, they thought. But creating a directory, which was a solution for them, did not even give the solution appropriately. Five directors were appointed, very obvious. They could not reach to consensus, and it was a very, very unstable kind of a government. And it led to these situations very, very aptly for a military upwheel or a dictator to rise. Let us see the changes by the convention. Adopted the metric system, dealt with final blow to feudalism, and system of laws were made, slavery was abolished, a public education system was even introduced. Directory suffered from corruption. People grew more poor and frustrated. Feeling of nationalism was fueled by the military successes of a leader as Napoleon Bonaparte. Situations were ripe for a dictatorial rule, which led to the rise of Napoleon. He made a lot of administrative and economic reforms, but was defeated at the Battle of Waterloo because of his too high ambitions to conquer the Europe and later the world. So here we could understand the in French Revolution, a lot of changes in the form of government were brought down step by step. Absolute monarchy was changed to constitutional monarchy. Then it witnessed the change as republic, later to a directory. And that also could not prove successful, so later Napoleon was there to head over. But from this chapter we understand what were the essential thoughts and brainstorming and changing thoughts from the French Revolution. It changed the scenario of the world in a U-turn. It was very, very obvious from this chapter we understand that liberty, equality, fraternity, which forms the basis of any kind of a democratic government, was only a dream and only a thing which could not be done. But within the process of French Revolution, we could see flowing down of these thoughts to the further countries and Europe, which later we will be able to understand in class 10. Thank you. I hope you understand this chapter very well.